Yo, what's up, Bully World? This is Big Mar, back with another webisode of Bully Code. This is part 17. And today I'm gonna lace y'all up on how to ship a puppy out. You know what I'm saying? Get a puppy gone. Because if you guys don't know what you're doing, it could be a pain in the ass. You feel me? Just like I had to find out. So I'm gonna lace y'all up so that way you guys could save yourself some time, some money. You know what I'm talking about? And get you guys going in the right direction. So, you got your puppy and you're ready to ship it off, right? Somebody hit you up, they paid you your money, which I highly recommend you guys use Western Union or MoneyGram. If you guys want to stay two steps ahead, just go ahead and have them send that money through Western Union or MoneyGram, like I said. And you guys know Walmart has MoneyGram, and there's Walmart everywhere, so that's like your best bet. Even down in Mexico, they got Walmart, so I would use MoneyGram if I was y'all. But anyways, back to my talk. I was saying, so you got your dog, you got to ship your dog, you know what I mean? You got to book it. So when you're booking your reservations, you're going to have problems if you call your dog a pit bull or American bully, because certain airlines don't even won't even ship the dog, period, point blank, because of the breed. And the ones that do, they have restrictions. If it's over 20 pounds, it has to be in a reinforced crate. And those crates go for anywhere from $600 to $1,300, excuse me, and that's just for the crate. So the way around that, I'm going to tell you the way around that. This is what I do. You know what I mean? I know a lot of OGs out there that have been doing this. This is what they do. When you call and you book your reservation, you got to tell them that your dog is another breed. So, like for me, my Sequoia and Agape litter, a lot of them, a majority of them was white. So when I did a lot of my shipping, I was calling them Dogo Argentinos. So when I go to the vet, you tell the vet you got a Dogo because it's all white. Now if your dog is red or black, you know, some people call them Labrador puppies, Great Dane puppies, whatever you gotta do to get this dog on the plane, you gotta do it, because they're gonna kick your ass with these reinforced crates. You feel me? And then, like I said, a lot of the other companies don't even fly our breed. So this is a way around it. So, you know, Google it. You know what I mean? I found a couple forums that gave up a lot of game. So I'm just going to let y'all know. Y'all can find the info for it. So if you got a black dog or a blue dog or a Brindle dog, what to call it. And you got to call it that when you go to the vet. So that way when you get your health certificate, it's on the health certificate as that breed. So when you book your call, you can be like, oh yeah, I got a, like for me, for instance, I got Dogos. I need to go ahead and ship off these Dogos. Okay, no problem. I get down there, you got to go get you a crate. You know what I mean? A crate, one size bigger than a puppy. You can go to Walmart, get you a crate, $75, $73. Bing, bam. Then you go to Petco and you get you the water bowls, the medium-sized water bowls. Well, they come in three sizes, small, medium, and large. And you got to get two of them, okay? So you lace your kennel up, you lace your kennel up with newspaper. The day you take your dog down there, you're going to have to get a bag of food, a little Ziploc baggie of food, you feel me? Your dog, your health certificate saying the name of the breed and that you booked that under that breed, you feel me? Then you got to go down to the airport. So let's say if you had a 7 o'clock 7 a.m. flight, you got to be down there 2 hours early, you feel me? So if I was you, I would get down there at 5, you feel me? Drop your dog off, check it in, bingo bango, you good to go. You get your confirmation number, get your flight number. Get all your flight numbers, you hit up the buyer, the receiver of the dog, you give them all the information, you feel me? So that way they know, you know what I mean, what they doing, what, you know, what to look for, what flight and all that good stuff. So that's, you know, that's pretty much the basics. So you guys gotta pay attention to these little loopholes, you feel me? Because if otherwise they're trying to get us. My dog was 21 pounds, you feel me? Little puppy, and when I was calling her a bully, they was trying to hit me with that reinforced crate. But as soon as I called her a Dogo, it was no problem. Oh, it's nothing. Okay, yeah, we'll go ahead and reserve that flight where you want to go, la 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 la. So y'all got to know what you're doing. You got to know what you're talking about. You know what I'm saying? The game is right here. Soak it up and don't have the same problems that I had to go through and a lot of other people had to go through. Another thing before I get out of here today, I had my boy, one of my boys hit me up on Facebook and want to know, Marv, what puppy, how do you know which pup to pick? So the way I go about picking my pups is you gotta wait straight up, because whatever comes out the biggest as a puppy, like when they're first born, whatever comes out big, the big boy or the big girl, it don't always mean they're gonna be the biggest one when they 12 weeks 14 weeks, you feel me? They go through a lot of changing, and so sometimes if you just got a monster in the litter and you just got a bull in the litter, he gonna be a bull and okay, cool. But every now and then you got your creepers, you got your ones that you never looked at, your sleepers, and those come out to, you know, they end up turning some heads too, you feel me? So but I always go for bone, chest, head, you know, shoulders, neck, rear. I check all that, you know, as much as you can in a pup, you feel me? And other than that, it's like it's like a luck of a draw, to tell you the truth, you feel me? Other than going for the pedigree, you gotta stack these pedigrees up so that way you know what you're getting, and you know, keep your fingers and your toes crossed, and maybe the man upstairs might bless y'all with the next hitter in the game, you know what I'm talking about? So that's how I do it. And then the last thing I was gonna tell y'all, y'all might have seen me rocking these, let me show y'all these boots. Y'all that's friends with me on Facebook might have seen me rocking my kennel shoes, my kennel boots. You feel me? Every kennel man should have a pair. You feel me? But I don't like wearing these all year long. We out here in California and we don't deal with rain that much. And you know, these is good for like right now, the cold season. I'll kick these bad boys on. They keep my feet warm. But like during the summertime and all year long, yeah, I'll pick these bad boys up for Big Five for $19.95. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about? So they work fine for me. So that's just a little, you know, a little something else to talk about with y'all. So this is Big Marv. I'm gonna start knocking out some more of these bully codes. I'm still doing the bully extras. I'm looking for a couple people that want to get on the bully extras. Hit me up. You know, we rolling. 2013 is coming. 2012 was a good year. I gotta move up my sleeve, y'all. Woo. I'm not even gonna get into that. Y'all about to just catch up with me. When it happened, I'm not saying nothing about it. It's top secret. This is fearless, top secret. You know what I'm saying? And that's how we're gonna have to keep that. So I love y'all out there. Keep tuning in. Subscribe. Tell your homies to subscribe, share. You know what I'm talking about? All that good YouTube stuff. We gonna keep it fearless on this bit more. Bully Code 17, and we a wrap. Yeah, that was hand.